Hi everyone, I hope you're doing fine. This is Connelly Gonzalez and welcome back to your Information Security Newspaper channel. Do you know that there is a technique to deactivate almost any antivirus program? Security researchers from RAC 9/11 Labs describe a technique that can disable almost any antivirus for Windows, macOS, and Linux. Even though antivirus are designed to protect against malicious threats, apparently there are ways to secretly disable them before they can neutralize a threat. What if an antivirus could be manipulated to perform certain file operations that will allow the operating system to be compromised by an attacker? Here is a technique that can be used to disable and to bypass almost any antivirus software for Windows, macOS, and Linux. When an unknown file is saved to disk, usually the antivirus performs a real-time scan, either immediately or in minutes. If this unknown file possesses a malicious threat, it's quarantined and moved to a safe location, or it's simply deleted. What most antivirus softwares fail to take into account is that a small window between the first scan, which detected the malicious scan, and the cleanup operation, which usually takes place immediately after. And the thing with virus scanners is that they run with the highest privileges, opening up a world of possibility to attackers looking to exploit security holes, and in this case, through race conditions. Someone can run a race condition via directory junction for Windows, or via symlink for Linux and macOS. This in order to exploit the privileged file operations of the virus scanner to disable the antivirus software. A directory junction is exclusive for Windows and it can link two directories together. It cannot link two files, and the directories need to be local to the file system. Directory junctions can be made by any user because they don't require administrator privileges, making it perfect for exploiting the antivirus software under the Windows operating system. And a symlink or a symbolic link is simply a shortcut to another file. It's basically a file that points to another file. It's more commonly used in Linux and in macOS, and any unprivileged user can make them. Windows also has symbolic links, however, by default, they cannot be performed by unprivileged users. Therefore, they will not be useful for exploiting an antivirus software. In tests made on Windows, Linux, and macOS, security researchers were able to delete and disable important files used by the antivirus software without any problems. Of course, these tests were focused on the self-destructive behavior of the antivirus. It is very possible that other files will have required escalation. And even though in Windows you can only delete files that are not in actual use, some antivirus softwares deleted those files once the system was restarted. Fortunately, the vendors have received each one a vulnerability report from the security researchers. It's up to them to make improvements, and you can actually go ahead and run the test with your own current antivirus. All famous antivirus are affected, and you can see them here on the list. I hope you liked the video. Don't forget to like and to subscribe. Click on the bell button. My name is Connelly Gonzalez, and I wish you the very best.